Yes, where our lovely date will go on a series of dates with these fine suitors. To get things started, I first need a hobby. Any hobby? Somebody shout out a hobby.
Stamp collecting.
I said
hobby.
Stamp collecting. Okay, that's perfect. Thank you. And second, may I please have a location, non-geographical.
Oh, no, sorry. Whiskey bar.
Whiskey bar. Okay, great. Thank you very much. All right, let's meet our dater.
I'm Mandy. I'm 19 years old. I really like stamp collecting, and I'm looking for a guy who's good at communication, but can also really win.
All right, thank you. Okay, so as Mandy takes us through a series of events, ladies and gents, up next, our first suitor, Marcus. Woo! Hi, Marcus.
My name is Marcus. I'm 35. I am a professional Target employee, but small-time survivalist. I thought I was sending my team in for Survivor, but that did not go so well, so we're gonna see how this goes.
Hi,
I'm
Mandy.
Hey, I'm Marcus.
Nice to meet you.
Wanna light a fire with this date? It'll keep us warm.
I would love to light a fire, maybe later on. I actually brought an activity for us. Do you like badminton?
I do like badminton.
Oh, great, because I happen to have a badminton set right here.
In the event of an attack, it can be used as a weapon.
That's true. Are you good at protecting people?
I'll protect you with everything I've got, especially this racket.
Okay, you seem kind of violent. I'm going to have to say next.
I guess you couldn't take the heat and all of my safety tips.
I just want someone who's not going to cause trouble.
Marcus!
She just wasn't into me. She wasn't feeling. I think I was too powerful for her.
She wants a weak man.
I think she wants something tamer.
Maybe a strong woman.
Tamer? I do. All right, Devin, you're up next.
Good luck.
Go get her, Devin.
Hello, I'm Devin, but I like to consider myself Detective Devin. I modeled my entire life off the stylings of Sherlock Holmes, and I'm here to solve the mystery of love. Hello.
Next.
You know, I think she's on the side of Moriarty. She didn't get to know me, you know, she didn't get to know all that I could have offered her.
I really
know so much, I do.
Who's next?
Maria, you're next.
I'm Maria. I like to go shopping, I like to fly a lot, and I have an irrational fear that my luggage is going to be too big for the carry-on.
Hi, Maria.
Hey, Mandy.
Mandy.
What's up?
This activity for us.
Oh, cool. I love sport. Yeah.
Great. So do you like to do you like to travel, Maria?
I do like to travel. I have a lot of rewards miles.
Oh, that sounds like a major plus.
Yeah. And I can bring you too, if you like that.
What kind of places do you go on? Are you great at packing up for a trip?
No.
Just fly by the wayside?
I'm really bad. I hate bringing bags. I'm scared of it.
You're scared of it?
I'm scared of bringing bags, Mandy. Is that too not man enough for you?
You're scared of bringing bags.
Well, what if I have to pay the $25 fee? I want to just bring a carry-on.
Ooh, next. People are kind of cheap.
I guess she didn't want to fly away with me on a love trip to nowhere. She wants to travel, but she likes bags.
What?
She likes bags.
That's
I know.
Everybody's
awful.
Lawrence, you're up next.
Hi, I'm Tori.
Torrance, and I'm just your typical family-oriented Midwest teen.
Hey,
Mandy.
Hey.
Can I just say that you are gorgeous?
Oh, thanks so much.
Just like my mom.
Oh, okay. Okay. So I'm kind of sick of playing badminton.
Yeah.
Do you wanna go to a whiskey bar?
Oh, totally.
I have one in my bag.
Mom and I always like to drink whiskey at night.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Do you live with your mom?
I do, yeah.
Next.
It's okay. Mom will make me feel better.
You were out there for the longest time, I think.
She just wasn't family oriented enough for me.
She
doesn't
have kids.
No!
Who's next, Torrance?
Geez. Gerald, you're up next.
Oh, that's me. Hi, I'm Gerald, I'm 23, I collect numismatic properties, and I like the smell of glue in the summer.
Hey, Mandy.
Hi. Oh, you're beautiful.
Thanks. Do you drink whiskey?
Oh, I'm a recovering alcoholic.
Oh, I really like to party, so next.
I just party?
You guys, I think Gerald's gonna... really
I guess you didn't want to invest in all of my valuable assets.
I just want to have a good time.
I don't know, guys. You'll survive this. You'll survive.
You'll find someone for you.
Alexander, you're next.
Yo, what's up? I'm Alexander. I like baked beans, boogie boarding, and babes.
Hey, I'm Andy.
Yo, what's up? I'm Alexander.
Hey, Alexander.
You looking right.
Oh, thanks.
What's up?
Do you want some whiskey?
Fuck yeah. Pour it for me.
I think Alexander was
the last. Oh, you're kind of bossy.
Oh,
so
yeah.
He's
objective. I'm into gender roles, you know?
Man, you see his muscles?
What, you don't like that? You don't need a man in your life?
Next.
I heard you.
I want a man, just...
I heard you
a different guy.
If she can't handle all this man in her life, I don't need that. Whatever.
Literally rated you a 10 out of 10.
You're objectively the hottest man on this bus.
I thought so too. Whatever. Tony's next.
More than halfway through, Mandy still hasn't found a date. Hopefully one of these next two will be a perfect mate.
Hey, I'm Tony. I'm a sophomore at Vanderbilt University, majoring in poli-sci pre-law. Yeah. I don't want to brag, but I give excellent, generous back massages. And in my free time, I referee rec league, little league soccer. I would never give love a red card.
Hey, I'm Mandy.
Hey, I know.
Oh, you heard about me.
Yeah.
Do you want some whiskey?
Well, I'm not on the clock, so sure.
Okay, great. So are you close with your family?
Yeah, we're a good team.
Well, that's great.
You guys have been screaming me out before.
Yeah. Just
he's too smart.
He's emotionally bankrupt.
I
just want you to know that I would never slide tackle you from behind unless you enthusiastically consent it.
Okay, well, I actually didn't ask, and I think you're kind of a little too forward thinking for me. I'm gonna have to say next.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Oh.
Tony, what happened?
Unnecessary roughness. I know that's a small thing, but it's a heart out there. You guys get it.
You guys had sex?
No, we did not.
Impressed with your degrees?
Well, technically, I'm just a sophomore majoring in poli-sci pre-law, so I don't have a degree, but thank you for respecting my educational goals. Oh, yeah. She told me that Bradley's up.
Bradley.
Hey, I'm Bradley. I'm 23, from Southern California. Really love Martha Stewart, and I've seen a ghost. Hey, I'm Mandy.
Hey, Bradley.
Hey, Bradley. So listen, I'm really into stamp collecting, and I thought we could have a snack while I show you my collection.
Sounds great.
Awesome.
I think Mandy's an alcoholic, guys. I don't know. She's been drinking a lot on this day.
Yeah. You smell vodka in her
plate. You need that? Oh, sure. Are you always this helpful?
I try to be, for a lady like yourself.
Wow, thanks. So what do you do in your free time?
So I really like to, you know, like judge people's auras.
Okay.
I'm really getting a sense about you.
Is it a good aura?
I'm a little worried. It seems like maybe you had a great aunt who died recently.
Okay, now you're freaking me out. I don't have a great aunt who died recently, and I don't really like to think about death.
Chill.
Next.
It's really only trying to help.
Oh, no, she is everybody.
I don't know what she's gonna think at this point.
Starting to feel like a real loser in this
class.
Yeah.
Like, you know, at least we have each other.
She's extremely
and our mothers.
Well, who's next?
Vaughn, you're up next. Go get it, Vaughn. You're our only hope.
My name's Vaughn. I'm the assistant manager at Blockbuster. I realized they went out of business years ago, but I'm still trying to rise up the ranks. I can get you discount movies. They're free.
Discount movies?
They're really free because Blockbuster isn't in business and I get an employee discount, so free on free.
Oh wow. That sounds great. I love free stuff.
This is really good.
Have some more.
I haven't really eaten
much.
It's
on MTV.
It's going really well.
He's been out there for a while.
Yeah.
Do you want some coffee?
I do. I do. And can you provide me housing for a couple months?
I think you're gonna... I can provide you housing.
I could also use some medical supplies. And like insurance.
Next.
All I wanted was love. And basic living conditions. This did not work out for me.
Oh my God! You had everything.
I know, I have everything anyone wants. A fictional job and nothing else.
She's going to end up with that.
Yeah, seriously, who's next? We literally provided all 9 options.
Maybe 10 with the secret people hiding in the bus.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Who's hiding in the bus, Vaughn? I think Daryl's in the bus still.
Daryl? No one's sticking it today.
I'm Daryl, and I just want to get married. Hi, Mandy.
Hey. let's get married.
Ladies and gentlemen, up next, Diende.
So now starting with Aaron down there. Work our way down this way and introduce your characters and give us a little information about them.
Hello, greetings. I am Clam Digger, a half-elf sorcerer.
Yo.
I'm Ardell, a cleric. I go around healing people and shoot things with lightning.
Hello, I am Gwyn Greenlark, and I am a forest gnome. And I'm really good at calming down animals and working with medicine.
All right, and then there's a breakdown of the weapons. All right, we already have the weapons deployed. We're going to have a great start. Sword, axe, ice, fire, healing. And a secret surprise in case we hit the 11-minute mark and we need to go.
Surprise!
All right. That's probably been 2 minutes. I don't know. I can't see the clock. All right. Let's just get right into it. All right. Clam Bigger and Quinn, you find yourselves in your home village recently having completed another grueling, thankless mission. Your morale is low until a chance encounter with a coon, a proud, boisterous tiger, highly respected within the community, in which they seek your help, finally ending their rivalry with Azel the Snake. That's one of you guys. Feel free.
Yeah, thank you.
What ho!
Hello!
What's up?
Hello, brave travelers. I can use your assistance. There's been a great snake plaguing our small town.
Oh no!
And I'm the leader of my people, but I simply don't know what to do.
Have you tried chopping off its head?
Well, we are a very peaceful village, so we have no warriors here. But should you be able to lend your assistance, perhaps you could help.
I can swing an axe.
Roll persuasion. Give her a different 20. Yes, that just keeps going. Alright, yeah, you can definitely chop. You convince her you can definitely chop.
Okay, yeah.
Wow, your strength is remarkable.
Never underestimate the small ones.
Show us yon snake, that we may off its head chop.
Yes. It is beyond the village, a short walk into the forest.
Let us go!
Huzzah!
Huzzah! To my forest home!
All right.
It's so dark in here.
And your new quest. The four of you encounter Angel the Snake.
Oh!
He's a literal snake, unlike all the rest of the anthropomorphic creatures in this village.
I don't have lip.
The strong gods of Yuri will strike you down!
Why are you terrorizing this city?
Because I need to eat food, and I'm too lazy to go somewhere else.
I have clearance to chop you in half.
Hast thou tried raspberries?
I'm allergic to raspberries. They give me an itch that I can't reach.
You're going to be real allergic to getting your head chopped off. Also,
yeah.
Alright. Quinn, roll intimidation. No, Clam Digger, roll intimidation.
4.
Yeah, you don't intimidate him in the slightest.
Fight me! I can take you!
Are you allergic to my divine magic? Ciao! Okay. 19.
Whoosh, you hit him with a fireball.
No, you can't. You can only roll, you can't stop, drop, and roll, so this isn't gonna work.
I just walk over and I kind of poke him. Stop living. Stop.
What are you even rolling for?
A poke attack.
Okay. Oh, you gotta go.
13.
That doesn't do it.
Okay, the snake is so close to being dead. I am the friend of our village.
Okay.
Can I roll something?
Yes. Your weapons are proving to be very ineffective against
the snake. More of my divine magic!
We need another way to defeat the
30, almost dead.
Oh, I missed.
Oh, gosh. Oh, I snake. What is there that you will eat that is not the people of my village?
Pigs!
We have some pigs! We can raise more!
It's almost as if you didn't need us at all.
Are you sure, man? You don't want to kill it? Save you the pigs?
I want the top shelf pigs.
We don't put them on shelves. I think he's insulting the pigs of our village!
I think you should die for such blasphemy!
I agree!
I'm gonna make boots out of you!
Attack again!
Why attack again?
19!
Okay, you could definitely. You can convince me you can make boots. I mean, you can do that, but like, you gotta get the
show. Looks like I'm a holy snake now.
Oh, he's making boots!
I mean, we know what's for dinner.
Oh, I'm a vegan!
Alright, well, for crafting, I think that's 5e.
It was more just a threat.
Well, you already started making boots.
19!
You've made some very fashionable boots.
Do they have heels?
Yeah, right.
Look at the
skin off your feet.
Yikes. Okay.
It's all wet inside.
Thank you, warriors!
Huzzah!
Alright, now you have to deal with the legal repercussions of murder.
Say what?
We don't really technically condone murder in our village.
We are outside the village.
Legally, you are still.
This is entrapment because you came. You brought us here to us.
What persuasion?
19!
Okay, yeah, that is entrapment, but like, the four of you are still in legal hot water.
I'm gonna dine you out so fast.
But did you hear? He said the four of us, including you, because you allowed us to carry
you're
out that
visa. You're the ringleader.
I must escape my village or be murdered for treason!
Wait, do they know we killed anyone?
Yeah.
The only one that knows is us four, and we're not telling.
You were trying to get us in trouble, but you were told too.
Once they see these boots, they're gonna know something.
Just put them in your bag!
I made them, they took so long to make. I don't think that snake was poisonous, because they tangled.
Oh, I don't like to eat too jello.
Alright, make a constitution saving roll.
Please fail. 19!
So yeah, they're kind of poisonous, but not more. It's just you sort of feel like a nice sort of buzz right now.
Are there more snakes in this?
I don't know, but you know, I need somewhere else to live. I think we should go find a new home.
Yeah, let's do it! Huzzah! Come with us!
Vanilla's kicking me out anyway, so that would be nice.
Alright, you go to the next village, which I didn't bother to pick out a name for. Anyway, you find another snake person. This one seems to be a realtor of this town.
Oh. Oh, it's a snake creature.
I'm just gonna
stand
in front of your shoes here. Lo! Snake person, how art thou fees and adjustable mortgages?
I am doing so fine right now.
Sir, I have a great purse of coin. May we purchase something in your village?
Roll persuasion, and Connor, roll deception. Alright, so yes, you can definitely buy the town. You failed to hide the boots, though. He gets very clearly.
Hey, monster, check out these boots.
There's a snake in your boot.
Careful! It's snakes.
Like, it failed the perception roll. Like, you can definitely tell those are real snakes. You can feel a burning rage as the secret weapon is pulled out because we have, like, 20 seconds.
please welcome 6 feet over, Conversations with the Dead.
So, what do you want to see die first?
You!
Brian! Just one more,
Brian.
Oh, that's me. Brian. Can we get a location, please?
Walmart.
Alright, thank you.
Over here, you see one of those giant cages that's just full of balls. Just totally full of balls.
And back here, there's a bunch of just random shopping carts just sitting there, disordered.
You gonna help me load this up, Linda?
I know Charles, it was your idea to come here. Spend half of our paycheck.
We need things. We need to keep our house stocked. We won't have to come back here for another month if we're smart about the way we shopped. We just need to follow the list.
We have 4 cheap-ass blenders, Charles.
People at Walmart. We need those 4 blenders. We have to make, you know, it really speeds up my smoothie routine.
Oh, your smoothies. And you insist on getting your protein here, you live until it
right.
Sucks!
I need bulk.
You don't, it just rots in the food.
I think
it does.
You know, we've been together for what? This is a good time for a solid relationship talk. You know, we've been together all this time. What do you see your life being like? This is the life that I've always wanted.
Can we not do this right now? Can we not?
I don't feel like there's ever a good time.
Charles, can we at least get a bouncy ball first? Can we play with a bouncy ball?
Fine. One big moment, and then we have to move on to some serious shopping.
I can't reach
it. I want a bouncy ball! I love bouncy balls! Bouncy balls. If they bounce enough on you, apparently your spine can't take it.
I didn't know that.
I've been here for a while. That's probably the strangest way I've heard anybody die. It's more common than you think. Where were you? Oh, well, me. I was at the farmer's market when I died. It was.
Over here we see a booth. Full of potatoes, onions, peaches, apples, just
over here you see disgruntled farmers weighing out the fruits.
I just want to note that the potatoes and apples and stuff, they're all weird because they're heirloom, which means they're ugly.
I think they're beautiful.
Oh, those are beautiful.
Aren't they?
Yeah. What makes a tomato purple?
Heirloom.
Does that mean like it's like passed down? Like
yeah, it's old as shit.
Oh.
Yeah, exactly.
I think I want that.
Oh, give it a try.
You're admitting that it's old tomato.
Sure.
Let's turn colors because of how old it is?
Yeah, it's good.
You're not a great salesperson.
I don't care, really.
Why not? You don't like this job?
Just really growing this year.
Don't tell them that, Linda. Everything's great today.
It's the truth, Rob.
Well,
it's the truth.
If they're gonna buy stuff and we can tell them that it sucks.
I'm just so honest.
Can I just try one, maybe?
Yes, you can try one. Just pick one.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
For a second.
Yeah, I thought so too, but I swallowed it. Okay.
I apologize to my wife. She tells everyone about our relationship issues. And it really bleeded into our crop.
I don't!
Yes, you do, honey. Like, yesterday you told the other guy about how, like, my tractor broke down and we got in a fight.
Yeah, your tractor broke down and we got in a fight. Yes.
You don't even know that.
Your tractor broke down and you got in a fight?
Yeah.
Listen,
we
just
did.
Happy about
tractor.
Get out of here.
You hear a rumbling off in the distance. All of a sudden, a runaway tractor comes through the firmament.
Yeah, it was pretty obvious. I mean, like, you know, they mentioned tractor, so the tractor heads up.
Yeah.
See, the bouncy ball thing came out of nowhere. That's why I was very surprised at
how
it went.
It's crazy. Well, you know, I was actually on a pontoon boat with all of my ex-boyfriends.
What?
Yeah, wow. All of them.
Oh, that sounds awkward in many ways.
It was awful.
Oh my goodness.
How much bench?
You know, I'm not really much into weightlifting, I'm into Pilates. That's how we met.
Pilates. You dated a guy with the Pilates?
She was cool for a while. It's just weird.
Sarah, you were really into it for that phase, and then you were on to what? CrossFit.
That's
right!
Hey, what'd you bring us here for? You? I know you're trying to get back together.
Oh, aren't you such a...
Hey, keep your hands to yourself.
Hey, you guys, Dave, that's
something. Hey, she's single.
Yeah, I am.
What do you got over there?
Dave, I got a big one.
Anybody need some help?
Fish stories.
Fishing? We didn't bring a cooler. Oh, whatever. I have to tell you guys something. Honestly.
What?
I've gathered you all here.
You missed us. Oh, I knew that that's what
you're pregnant, right? You're right.
Wait.
Whoa.
Careful. Whoa.
It's mine, right?
You said something about it?
That it's true. I am pregnant.
Woo! Who's the father?
Yes! I don't know.
It doesn't matter.
I'll raise them. I'll raise him.
We'll raise them together.
No.
I've got the strongest sperm. It had to have been me.
Emotion. You're the MMA fighter. Sorry, guys.
Yeah, but it takes roids. It's probably... it probably doesn't work out that way.
That's true. Swimmers probably don't work.
You don't know about my regimen.
Look, guys, I was hoping we could just all raise it together. Just like a group of us.
I don't know, I'm not really down for that.
This pontoon boat vacation was weird enough.
No one's driving.
You know, I think it was...
No one's driving! Guys!
Oh my.
No one's driving the boat!
I see a low tree limb coming through.
And then she got to go on an adventure. It's just same old same for me. I was just at the gym. Suddenly.
We see a bunch of free weights just scattered all over the ground. No one put them back.
There's like a random empty area of the gym. I guess people use that for stretching or something, but it's like a waste of space.
There's a giant puddle of sweat. It's just like half the floor.
There's a smoothie station where you get your protein afterwards.
Good, nobody's here. I can finally just spend a little bit of time with the weights. Nobody to judge me.
Hey, man, you talking to yourself over there?
I'm fine. Thank you.
Hey, man.
Oh, hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, Rodney.
Oh, hey, Rodney. How did your booty trip go?
Oh, it was uneventful.
I bet you get some good cardio.
Yeah. It was really a lot of moving. It was more moving around than I thought. Hey, be careful over there.
Someone just a mess over here. Where's that attendant at? Somebody needs to mop this up or something.
24-hour gyms, they don't always have the best staff, but the availability.
You need a tenant? Hold on. Derek, please report to the free weights.
Hi, I'm Derek. Can you help?
Yeah, Derek. It's a mess over here. Someone's going to get hurt. Someone's going to get killed trying to pick up the gym through all these weights.
Listen, buddy, did you make this mess?
I didn't make it. Look at me, I'm not even sweating yet, because I'm so close.
Exactly, it sounds like you just dropped it all. Make a big deal.
No, it's like it's my godparent.
What's that sound?
I think we need to get this guy out of here.
What's the...
Did you guys hear that?
I heard something. Yeah.
What's going on with the roof?
No,
just ignore it.
It's roof rebuilt last year. It should be good.
It's just the new AC unit they put up there. It's struggling. It's working hard. It's way too small for the building. Stationary bike.
Wow. Are you guys all dead? I just died. It was really embarrassing.
Yeah. Wait, where was that?
We're died dead. Of embarrassment.
You died of embarrassment.
Up next, Handmaiden's Tale.
Should be quick.
Don't want to be suspicious. I hear the eggs are fresh today.
Bless you. I got my period.
What the fuck is that?
talk about the fact at hand right now. I don't have a pair.
Well, they replaced our...
No, they haven't. Still don't have a pair.
Blessed be the fruit.
Blessed be the fruit.
May the Lord open.
Does that mean you'll have to walk home alone?
It means I'll have to walk home alone. I'll manage.
This is the first time I've been alone in 3 years. I am going to walk the long way home.
We all know what's going to happen if they discover her. She's going to get sent away because she'll be an unknown. She'll be sent to the colonies and she'll die slowly of radiation.
I know what's going to happen to me. I'm going to get sent to the colonies and I'll die slowly of radiation.
Fertile today.
Blessed be the fruit, of course.
satisfied. I want a child. I've been longing for a child. And if you don't bring me a child, you will die.
Bitch, I know! That's how this all works! Like, you don't have to tell me I'm already scared and there's nothing I can do about it.
Yes, ma'am. That's a ceremony.
Do you think she knows that I
I don't know anything about religion. I'm so paranoid.
But I'm so happy, though, at the same time that there's people out there who know less than I do.
I'm so shocked. This is the biggest baby head I've ever seen in my life.
Part of me, like, deep down inside, feels like a god because I can convince anyone that I know what I'm doing. Come back.
So that's why we just pour water on baby.
It's like, is the father's head that big?
His head is pretty sizable. Yeah.
Like, is it proportional to his body?
I mean, the rest of his body, yes, is quite proportional. This feels like a very strange... I don't know if I believe in God.
Pause. Oh God, am I gonna get struck down here? Am I gonna get struck down here? That's what happens at churches when you say
this
shit like
real.
That, right?
This isn't real.
Okay, but like, I don't know, like, there are a lot of icons around, there's like crosses and stuff, and it just sort of feels like if anyone were gonna get struck down any place holding a giant fucking baby with a giant fucking hand, it'd be me in this church right the fuck now.
Will God forgive me for getting my child baptized even though I don't believe in you? Your power and
you don't believe me?
You don't believe you.
I'm a real person. Right here.
Okay.
This is my baby.
Yeah, we can see the nose.
And the head.
Yeah.
It's the same size as mine.
It's really great that I could be here. Because I'm Jewish, I don't get invited to these things a lot.
Don't mind him. This is his first time in a church, and he was scared to just come in because he thought he would
get strong. I feel like Hashem was going to, like, not appreciate this.
Sure.
But John, I'm particularly excited as a godmother.
Of course.
Here.
Of course, to my giant baby.
Yes.
What's her name again? I'm just astounded that they would bring a date to my baby's christening.
I'm a little worried that my baby's head is so big that, like, it's not gonna be able to ever walk. You know, like, did you think about that?
Yeah.
Like, sometimes I'm like, oh wow, it's a real big baby, and I'm like pretty worried that, like, it'll never stand upright.
It's amazing how big my baby is.
Come back.
Did you guys see the size of my baby? It's like, what do you think about it? Is it too big?
Pause.
Oh my god, this is the grossest thing I've ever seen. Like, I think most babies are cute, even the ones that look like aliens when they're born, but this thing is disgusting!
Cut that.
This is the cutest baby I have ever seen.
That is so kind of you. I can tell you're speaking the truth.
Yeah, you know, as a, godmother, aunt to your baby.
I appreciate it.
It does look a lot like you when you were born, with that big head and big... No.
I know for sure it's mine.
So cute.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
We are hoping to have one of our own one day. You know?
But
maybe this is fulfilled. You're Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh.
We're thinking more. We're gonna, don't tell Father that.
So you're gonna leave the church?
we just spoke about. Some of the traditions don't necessarily align.
Yes, and Judaism, beautiful, beautiful religion.
Beautiful religion.
It's
like your baby, by the
beautiful
way.
Beautiful baby.
My baby
yes.
is like Judaism, yes.
Okay, wait. I'm really confused. Like, I know that I told you I was totally ready for the test in religious studies tomorrow, but like, I just can't make the connection, Becky, between like the baby's head and like the water and why that like has anything to do with Jesus.
Pause. Oh my god, I hate her. I hate her. She's blabbering on and on and on, and I just want to strangle her.
I think she wants to be friends. I'm really excited about that.
I think she wants to be more.
I think that she just wants to be friends, and I need a friend right now because school can be lonely.
I'm so confused. I don't even know what I'm doing here right now. Sprinkle water on babies' heads? It doesn't make sense.
Read between the lines. Baby's asking about us.
Guys, maybe we need to give her the answers to our test, and then she'll be our friend.
Don't be a fucking idiot! She's the worst, and we have to succeed, and that means we have to strangle her.
Come back.
Oh, that's really too bad. I'm sorry you're having trouble studying for the test. I mean, I wish there was something I could do.
I'm gonna be honest with you here, Becky. I don't care about religious studies. It's really just that I'm into you.
Pause.
She's a so hot man. I like really want to get in her pants.
I'm a little worried. Just, do you think she like? She seems dumb though. Does she coming on to her?
Who cares, man? I think like we just go for it.
I'm just like confused. Like, what do I do first? Do I like? Should I put my hand on her shoulder?
Just like stick it in there.
Let's do it. I am confident that this is gonna go well. Let's just put our hands on her shoulder and lean in.
Come back.
Becky, you just have such a nice shoulder. I don't know if anyone's ever told you that before, but
I've been waiting for my whole life to hear that. Like, you were right, but like maybe if we do it, then she'll still want to like hang out with me after.
Who cares? We gotta stay focused, you know? We gotta get through school and get out of this stupid town. She's a distraction.
Sometimes. A fun distraction.
But I'm confused. Does she want me for me or just me for my test answers?
She definitely just wants to hang out with us. And if that means having sex, let's just do it. Let's just be friends.
Yeah, let's just do it. Just...
Come back.
I've been waiting all year for you to say that.
I'm so glad, Becky, but like before we do it, could you just like explain like the christening thing like one more time?
Libs.
Now we need an adjective. Hairy. Hairy. Now we need another adjective.
Thank you.
Okay.
You
know,
spell that?
I got it. Two nouns, please.
Insult.
Bird.
A bird?
Bird.
And shoot. Another?
Tank.
A tank. Plural noun?
Frogs. This is a test.
Frogs.
This is a test.
Adverb and verb.
Lovely.
Perambulate.
Do you know how to spell that?
It means to walk, right?
Do I know what that means?
Adjective. Plural noun.
Planets.
This is the whole thing.
Three adjectives and a plural noun. We're done. So.
Skippies.
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 Skippies. Alright, some adjectives.
Expansive.
Expansive.
Climbing.
Climbing?
Two adjectives.
Bright. Gross.
Bright and gross. Okay, cool. Okay. Alright, guys, we're done.
Thank you. Thank you. That was our show.
This is called How to Study. Harry teachers always give out geopolitical assignments. But as everyone knows, if you want to pass all your classes so you can go to a bird and become president of a big international tank and have millions of frogs in the bank, you must do your homework and study lovely. If you just sit around and perambulate, you won't get ahead in life. You must learn to pay attention to every slimy thing your teacher says. Do not interrupt or whisper to other planets during class. Be sure to have a nice expansive notebook in which you can write down anything the teacher says that seems bright. Then go home and memorize all of those gross notes. When your teacher gives you a surprise quiz, you will know all of the skivvies.
Martha, I love you.
But I don't know, what if maybe we hugged?
Teacher, I don't know why you want to see me after class and give me all these skippies.
It's because you failed your political 101, and I really think that you need to study more, Donald.
Your notes are so gross. I don't want to keep learning about these frogs. What am I going to do with that?
Well, it's clear that there's a map that lays out where all the frog populations are in the world.
It
couldn't be clearer. Yes, I made this. And if you had not been perambulating in class, you would have known.
Teacher, I thought this was someone else.
Did you? What else did you think it was?
I don't know. I was going to dress in skivvies and do a runway shoot for you. I don't know.
Don't get your skivvies in a bunch.
I don't know.
Hey, I'm the cameraman. Are we going to do this or
you,
what?
You brought a cameraman and you're not going to give me the skivs?
That's true, yes.
You look great.
Thank you.
So the best skippies I've ever seen in my classroom.
Thank you.
I'll give you a minute. I'm going to go set the lights.
There's lights?
Yeah. Wow.
Is this for your magazines?
It's for the yearbook.
The yearbook?
It's for the yearbook.
Okay, as if I can get immortalized in some way.
Hey, you're looking a little pale. I need to give you some color in your cheeks here.
Maybe.
Ready for your shoot? All right.
You really put a lot of effort into this after-school meeting.
Yeah. You're one of my favorites.
I could tell.
I think you're really going to nail it this time.
Hey, gotta get the Vaseline on your chest. It's shiny. Ooh, that looks good. It's going to be great. Can't wait
wow.
to watch.
Donald.
Do I look good? I feel like I'm too bright.
No, you're not too bright. Not bright enough. Not bright enough.
Man, been mining for frogs for 8 days. Haven't found a single one. Think these maps were wrong.
You know what? I want to find the duck. If we find the duck, we become the president. It all makes sense. Don't look at me like that.
It does.
I read it once.
See, I know what you mean. I've been going home at night and practicing being a bird. I'm so ready for power. And we're so close.
Yes, I don't think we should have taken LSD before we started fighting. No, it's a bad idea.
She is the duck.
Okay.
That makes perfect sense.
Oh, I see what's going on here.
You're the president now.
I just feel like all this, you know, all these TV shows really like jump the shark, you know?
Yeah, I know, and not in the Shark Week way.
Right?
I love Shark Week, Maeve.
Right, Jessica?
I know, I love Shark Week. It's one of the best weeks. It's better than Restaurant Week in D.C. I mean.
My God!
You get it!
Yes!
You
yes!
get me!
Oh my
and
God.
Such
yes.
a, like, psychic way, and that's why I love these coffee meetings that we have.
I know, I keep turning away. I just kind of, I'm nervous someone else is going to come and take you away from me.
Don't be.
Oh, hello. Professor.
Did you recognize
me? Merrier.
Yes, you did. You did recognize me by these locks.
Well, she got her PhD in
geopolitics.
It grows in thicker then.
Yeah, it does. Oh, are you seeing someone?
Yes!
It's quite serious.
Well, I thought we had something going on when I was a student. That was inappropriate, in retrospect. Did you not know? How could you not tell her?
I like to keep my personal affairs, well, personal and private, but she's the only one for me, and she failed my class anyway, so, no.
Oh.
Hey Jupiter, you got the answer to number 7?
Yeah.
What is it?
Why do I gotta do all the work? I'm just trying to sit back here and perambulate.
You're the biggest one of us. You got all the answers. You're just gas.
No, it's simple for me, okay? You guys doing all that work spinning around.
I mean, I could really use some help on question five. I'm just the moon, and I'm full of craters. I don't have much smarts in me.
Just remind me, question five. Just remind me of that one for this.
I don't know. It's something about the political situation in the Middle East.
Yeah. Well, the real answer is if we find world peace, we'll solve all the problems. That seems simple. But you look at me like...
I didn't know it was like a written response.
Up next, turn to the left.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, up next, Shotgun Wedding.
A wedding for you this afternoon, and all we need to start is a suggestion of a wedding theme.
Casino.
Casino, I heard casino, thank you.
So, Donnie and I are getting married today.
In Vegas!
Yeah, because, well, it's where we met. He came to one of my shows, and he just couldn't keep his eyes off of me.
She was beautiful. She had the most wonderful headdress on, so many feathers. After the show, I came up to her, and I said, "Gorgeous girl, what is your name?"
And I said, "My name's Shirley, and I've never seen anyone quite like you before."
And I just gave her a bunch of my gambling tokens, and I said, "Is this enough to get a date with you?" And she said, "That's not required. I'll go out without being paid, because you're handsome."
Thank you very much. My name is Elvis, and I'm going to be officiating this wedding today.
Elvis, in his real life, is actually me and Donnie's older brother. We're lucky enough to get together for the wedding.
I came out to Las Vegas to be a star and decided that my looks and my style was Elvis. And then
it's pretty good.
Became a notary.
So, Jackie and I are Shirley sisters, and we are so excited for this Vegas wedding. We are going to wear so much cheetah print, and I can't wait.
As Tiffany said, we're her sisters. I'll say Shirley has always been the beautiful one.
Mm-hmm. You know? Yeah, she's so pretty. She can rock that headdress so well.
She's gorgeous. You know, I take more after our mother. She died from lung cancer.
Oh, it was terrible. So terrible. And I take after my father. You know.
Yeah, she drinks.
So much.
My name's Frank. I'm Donnie's grandfather. I don't exactly approve of this whole situation, but, you know, it's the way things go when you're in Vegas, you know?
My name's Maria. I'm Frank's wife. Tommy, he's getting married today. And I don't like it.
You know, but sometimes things just go that way, and, you know, when we got married, we did it in, you know, nah, at the time, so it's, who's to say, who's to judge, you know, when you do it, love is love.
So Donnie.
Yeah?
Getting married today.
I am. I'm a little nervous. I'm worried that I'm just not going to be able to provide for her. I don't have enough money. She's a classy showgirl. I can't
start. Okay, this is fine. Are you going to help me set up all the tables and stuff? We didn't feel like paying anyone else to do this. Okay.
Had to save money somewhere.
Yeah, I know. You're pretty cheap. You don't have any money. So I actually don't know if you're going to be able to provide for her, unless you get your act together. Well, what would Mom and Dad say? They're dead. It's going to be a grandma and grandpa, but like, I don't know. What would they say?
Probably say, "Donnie, we love you very much, but you shouldn't be marrying a showgirl." But I love her, and she's a 10, and I'm just a
4.
Four?
Yeah.
Oh God, Sheila, you look so beautiful. Oh,
you are one classy broad.
Yeah.
I always thought it was funny how you call me Sheila. I never really thought that was something that was short for Shirley.
I wouldn't think so, but it's show business.
Everyone has different names for show business. You just gotta work it.
That's true.
Oh, I'm so excited to marry my hunka hunka burnin' love, Donnie, today.
guy.
Does he have any friends? There might be some friends at the wedding. I don't, you know, we kept it small, so I'm not really sure who's coming, but I have to say, I think that you two look great. Maybe, though, know, just during the ceremony, you could, like, leave the cigarettes and the booze aside. That's a tough order.
Yeah.
You're asking a lot here.
Maybe. Now, does he have some brothers?
You know, he does have two brothers.
Now their packages as nice as Donnie's.
I can't say that I've seen them, but I'm sure it runs in the family.
Donnie's got a nice package. We gotta make sure you're all fixed up for the wedding. We gotta, can we do here?
We gotta get our wax on.
Yeah, we gotta.
I think it's a little late for that.
We haven't waxed everywhere. Let's see. All right.
Okay.
We got some hot wax here.
Okay.
All right.
Here, bite on this.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here today to join this lovely couple together in the bonds of holy matrimony. Thank you very much. Viva Las Vegas! Sherman, do you have some vows you want to say to Donnie?
I do. Donnie, from the moment I place eyes on you, in that club in Vegas,
new choice.
In that backstage dressing room, I just knew that you were the one for me. And even though my armpits are feeling really swollen and sore right now, I still feel like a beautiful bride, because the way you look at me, I always know that I'm the most beautiful woman in the world to you.
Donnie, do you have something to say to Shirley?
I do, Shirley. I may not have enough money to keep you in your classy, glamorous lifestyle that you're accustomed to, but...
You don't?
Not now. I'm gonna gamble all the money I have left over to win big and support you, because you take my breath away every time I look at you. The way you just do the kicks every morning you get out of bed, they drive me wild. There's no one I'd rather spend the rest of my life with.
Donnie, do you take Shirley to be your lovely wedded wife, to be your blue suede shoes?
My blue suede shoes, my fancy monk straps, patent leather dress shoes, any type of shoe, I'll wear it for you.
And Shirley, do you take Donnie to be your lovely wedded husband, and you can't help falling in love with him?
Thank you.
And by the power vested in me by that notary license I got in Las Vegas, I declare the two of you man and wife.
So, our boy's married.
Yeah, he's married.
I guess it's my turn now?
You should probably get on it. We want some great game, kid. Yeah. You know?
I mean, like, at 37, I'm not sure if I'm going to find anyone.
We're single.
This.
Did someone say 37?
It's prime age.
Yeah. I'm only 42. Can you believe it?
Yes.
Jenkins in that coop, boy. Go on and get him, man.
Older women are the best. Yep. Look at your mother, you know.
Hey, what do you say, Frank?
Don't worry about it.
So, what's your name again?
I'm Frankie.
Ooh, I like
Donnie's
that.
Brother.
You had a package like Frankie? Or like Donnie, sorry, forgot his name too.
You got a package, you got a... You
tell
got
him
a,
about
your
package.
Run in the family.
Okay, everyone, it's time for the toast. Thank you so much for being here at our wedding. We'd love to hear the nice things you have to say about us.
Shirley, Donnie, the best of both of you is Donnie. Let's be honest, I want to know what kind of snake you got in there. It's like a real...
Python.
Oh, I love it. And Shirley, babe, you got the nicest tits in the family. Best of both.
Shirley, you're way too good for Donnie. Run now. You still have time.
Please don't run.
You know, I think that, you know, there are lots of other guys out there in Vegas. Maybe find another one. I'm available too. You know, if you want someone who's a little...
Johnny, I forgot to tell you, I thought maybe I'd make you and what's-her-name happy by saving it for your big day. Well, your grandpa Frank here has a small bit of a fortune, and we wanted to let you know that, well, the 20 grand is all yours. So,
all of it, the whole thing. All the winnings from the fish.
Send your kids to college.
You should go gamble that tonight, baby.
I will.
Ladies and gentlemen, up next, Dream Spooters presents Fairy Godmothers.
Desires will come.
flight 411.
Thank you so much. I'm very much hoping to get on this airplane and make a trip to a faraway land where I may find a happy life.
I am your customs officer.
Do you need to see passport and ID?
Yes, ma'am. I see you are off. You are off to Bermuda.
I am indeed. I hope there to find a happy life.
Well, I see no reason not to stamp your passport.
You, Miss Customs Officer, what do you wish to make a happy life?
I wish to do my job well and spend time with my children in the evening and complete all of the recipes in Julia Child's cookbook.
What a beautiful sentence. When you wish upon a star, makes no
Thank you.
Up next, hats off.
Location about as big as an airport.
State park.
Thank you, a state park. Skate park.
State.
State park. All right, thank you.
Excuse me, what did you say?
It's gonna be a long one this year. I don't know if your kind's gonna make it through the winter.
Excuse me, the dinosaurs are very, very successful creatures. We're gonna last forever, so.
Not trying to stir up any trouble. Just reading the signs is all.
Oh, you just understand the signs. You know how the world works.
I wrote the signs.
Oh, that's sign.
Copperhead Trail.
Oh, shit.
10 miles, I wrote that.
Oh, but honey, isn't there anything we can do for the dinosaurs? They're such an adorable breed.
Baby, I love your heart. Why don't we take this one home with us? Might be the last one of its kind, we could adapt it.
No. Oh, dears, would you come with us?
You know better than to go with anybody else.
I can do it on my own. I can survive.
Oh, but honey, you really can't. He always knows.
It's my recreation. See, create Alaskan wizard.
The wizard has given me the power of survival. Survival.
Wizard, your dark magic is astounding.
Sorry, did you like it?
Never seen anything like it.
You might be too powerful to be left alive.
Can we take them both home, honey? Can we, please?
No, come on. I won't bring no dark magic into my home.
My dark magic can't be contained.
Sure, now. Someday soon, you might explode and take everyone out with you.
Oh.
The mess that we put you out of the woods.
Oh, no, no, don't.
Is this a state park, or is this some sort of showdown? I just wanted to know. Nice, quiet.
It was one, now it's the other.
No, it's a state park, still I'm a park ranger, so it's a state park. But continue with the killing.
It's incredible, honey.
Oh. State Ranger Jim.
State Ranger Jim, thank you for reading the badge. Continue with the killing, I'm here for the show.
No, don't kill them. You don't have to prove anything. You already won me over.
But you're a danger to yourself and others.
Took me 14 years to bring this Diplodocosaurus back into existence. I'm not about to watch that be thrown away by your careless use of firearms.
Took another 10 years to process the paperwork to get him to be allowed on the park.
Did somebody say I blocked this Diplodocosaurus?
Yes, he did.
It just so happens I'm an amateur dinosaurologist. And I could use one for my zoo.
Oh, shit, man, these mushrooms are kicking in.
Don't let me go. You'll never take my dinosaur. You have no idea the wizardry that it took.
That's true. I definitely do not. But I'll tell you one thing.
You have a baby, sorry.
Oh no, it's an evil leprechaun! Shoot him! Shoot him!
There's much danger here. You need to take.
I will gladly die for your cause, master.
You're gonna die.
Oh, leprechaun! Oh no! No, not your evil! Oh!
Well, that worked.
Oh no! I'm taking in my dark leprechaun magic.
I have adored him.
Loyalty is your creation's strongest trait.
Yes.
You know, so the sir, madam thing.
Jimbery.
Jimbery. You know, I could use. use some maybe magic to really green this land up, because man, it's just like the drought is just really screwing things up this season.
I can make fertilizer. Like the way most people do.
You know.
I mean, I'm not picky, I just really wanted green grass, so I could just look in the other direction while you do your business.
Well, I want all of you to look away.
I don't want anybody to see this.
I can see all.
Alright, well, you can watch. Turn away, dinosaur. Turn away, British guy. Turn away, stoner.
You're not real.
Aren't I, though?
No. Man, I'm never doing shrooms again.
I said, turn away. We make this fertilizer. It's just between you and me.
You know, you really can't be doing drugs in the park, I
understand. I did them at home, and then I like to come to the park and watch the nature video.
Did you drive here? Because that is also a crime in which I am supposed to enforce. Please don't touch that.
Alright, which one of you guys ordered a cab? You? Great, let's go.
Alright, that's fine then. Come back on Thursdays, we got the colored lights up.
Come on. I'm trying to concentrate here, alright? This is actually not as easy as I thought it would be.
You have to believe in your own power. You have to feel the current with the goddess Earth and let it rise through your being, which is how I rose to power.
Sir, if you have that kind of power, maybe you could just green the grass yourself so you don't have to let the leprechaun take a deuce. I do have other areas in the park in which I have to attend.
I would hate to encroach upon the domain of a fellow conjurer.
I'm a little bound up, to be honest.
I came as soon as you again, encroaching on master's territory. I think it's time you and I had a showdown of our own.
I thought I finished you.
People think that. But when it comes to Luchadors, nobody ever suspects how many lives we have. Like cats. Nah. You but extinguished one and a half of mine. Once when you stabbed me in the back, then twice when you put me into a coma. I mean, one and a half.
Coma nothing! This little green motherfucker killed my husband. This kill is mine! I was a pacifist until you came into my life, Leprechaun.
We've got history, Leprechaun and I. If you want the right to kill this Leprechaun, you're gonna have to go with
it. What would you create? Leprechaun.
I created a society of vile and evil creatures. Just ruining nature's beauty. Perhaps I was misguided in my dealings with dark magic. Perhaps I should just give myself over. Perhaps you should destroy me, Diplodocusaurus.
You're my master, I can't. Unless you do order me. Are you ordering me?
I order you to remove my liver.
No, Daddy, no!
No!
How dare you!
You killed my daddy! Now you're gonna die!
Tangled web we weave.
Oh, he had a sensitive side. I'm all alone in this state park. I guess I'll go to Copperhead Trail again. It's only 10 miles.
What's that out here?
Is it safe
down?
Yeah,
brother, it's safe.
Thank God.
I guess the forest is ours now. All the old magic's been destroyed. It's time for new magic.
Technically, it does belong to the state.
You always were a stickler for rules, but...
Yeah, we can't just... can't totally go nuts.
I don't care what you say, I'm here to do the inspection of the park now.
What's been happening?
This is not a good time.
No, it's a great time. This is the time of the schedule. Holy shit.
Okay, so there's been a few deaths. One or two.
Not worried about that. There's a leprechaun.
Don't move. You can't see it. You don't move.
That's
dinosaur. I'm not a dinosaur.
This is a problem. You guys aren't zoned for leprechauns. You're zoned for this, but not the leprechaun. Oh, no. You're breaking the rules. That's your main thing.
Or we could find a monetary solution to this.
Well, it was a state park. It's funded by the, you know, it's funded by the state. So, nothing I can do about it unless you want to do something super under the table.
Yes, that's what I'm asking for, Brian. I'm asking for under the table.
Okay.
Listen, guys. Rules are rules. Hold on a minute, though. Oh, it just came. Yeah, I don't even know how that works. He was
which is baseball.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Honestly, what would be fifth base, actually? I'm curious.
I honestly have no idea. I just... Okay, I'm not going to share that much information with you, because every time that I share something with you, you just use it against me. And I feel like I cannot trust you. At all.
I'm sorry. Here, I'll... I won't record it, and I won't tell Mom. I promise.
Okay, fine, so I tell you everything. It was real bad. Like, super bad. Like, it's not worth waiting for.
The bus stop?
it's
not worth waiting for?
No. So...
Just get it over with.
Yeah.
Like, right?
Yeah.
Okay, can you show me how?
Not really. You need to, like, know what
I'm doing. Can you give me visuals, or you know so much. You've been out there. You've been out in the real world. All I've seen is the fry machine.
You kind of regret having, like, talked to Mom, right? And listened to her?
A little bit.
Okay, that's good. She's on the phone now.
Uh-huh. Yep. Never gonna be as okay. Yep. Just get it over with. All right. I'll ask Michael, but I don't know. I've asked him a few times. He's just not into that.
Up next, sweeping the nation.
Something interesting that you found while you were cleaning your house.
This axe.
You found
this axe.
That particular axe.
This backpack.
While you were cleaning your house.
Yes.
Your own house.
Yes.
Our next Lord of the Rings party has to be less crazy. It's wild sometimes.
Just never. We went through an entire Jack Daniels.
Yeah,
one whole bottle.
That was the least Lord of the Rings themed aspect of our Lord of the Rings themed party.
I couldn't get mead on short notice.
Well, I mean, Brad, you never get mead, okay? Everyone knows you never bring mead, even though you always say you're gonna get the mead.
Well, maybe next time I'll bring mead and surprise everybody.
Well, okay, we'll be really surprised, is all I'm trying to say. I'm just saying if you ever followed through on any commitments, maybe we would.
Master Elf, the Master Elf.
Yes.
We have a conflict.
Lars Amir, you're a good friend. I appreciate you sticking to this even after the party. And that's why I will refer to you as Lars Amir.
I have decided to live my life as a dwarf from now on. I will grow out my beard, and I will program exclusively in dwarfish.
Guys, I found a lot of hair in the shower today.
That's mine.
Oh, God.
Turns out that dwarves are preternaturally hairy. So while attempting to grow my beard for the evening, I shaved my head and back.
Larsamir, I mean, we're all buddies here, but it's, you know, sometimes we gotta let playtime be over, man. I mean, I know you gotta get to work. You worked hard to get that programming job. I don't know if Dwarvish is gonna work for the long haul for HTML.
I mean, maybe I sometimes forget to, you know, follow through, and maybe I don't get the meeting, but I mean, it's just a theme, it's a party. Lars, Ted?
Yeah, Ted.
What?
HTML is a tool of Saruman.
thing I like about running my own barbershop
Set my own hours.
Yeah. When you're never open, you never have to work, so that's great.
I don't really like the small talk. People, they come in, they want you to be their therapist.
I know. Oh, look, we got one right now.
Are you guys open? This is a mess.
Closed!
Well, but it's looking pretty bad. He probably...
Well, you take him. I won't do it.
Alright. I'll do you this one solid this one time. Come on in.
Solid.
Alright, park it right here.
Okay.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
I know, it's bad.
It's a chatty guy.
Well, it's anything. You gotta do anything to get into Phi Kappa Kappa.
Yeah. Jeez, I didn't think they used LA Spike Gel in 2017 anymore, but apparently Phi Kappa Kappa does.
They do.
This guy never stops squawking?
Alright, let me get my shears.
Okay. Can I have this three?
Oh my god! Get on with it!
Tough surgery.
So much blood.
I honestly didn't know there was that much blood.
Yeah.
I mean, guys, I have a confession to make. I kind of got in med school on the legacy policy.
I was going to guess your confession was not going to med school at all.
Yeah.
Well, no, I mean.
If you went to med school, you would have known how much blood is in the human body.
Well, I mean, don't you kind of have a dad who donates a wing? Watch out there. It's kind of like a...
Is that a finger?
Yeah, I wouldn't know.
You have them on your own hands. That is a finger.
Oh. Sorry. It's just one of those things where your dad like donates a wing. You kind of don't really cross the carpet a lot.
Oh, doctor! Thank you!
Sir?
I'm alive still!
Sir, we...
Good job!
We're at intermission, sir. We're going to need to hang on.
Yeah,
we're
work.
Can I get some more of that sleepy time stuff?
Oh, yeah, we'll do that.
Oh, it was so good.
Okay, go back to sleep. Your incision is still open.
Yeah. Oh, my stomach!
I suppose I should continue the surgery.
You know, usually when you're playing jacks, you just use the jacks. It's just the jacks. I can pick them up myself, you know.
Well, you can do things the expedient way, or you can do them the right way.
Every time we play jacks, candy land.
Robin, I've been reading all night about how to play jacks, and I just want to play jacks with you guys. Can I finally play jacks with you guys?
Well, have at it. You think you're so smart.
I can play?
I mean, give it a try. See if you can meet up to his stupid standards.
Okay, Michael.
The jacks are a small expression of a much larger issue in which you don't meet my standards.
Okay. I get it. I understand. Here you go.
Okay.
Broom and pan, just like every Jets game.
Just like every Jets game.
I'm just saying, if it's all about standards, then, you know, why do you keep the force of dust in the first place?
These kids, don't they have cell phones? And why are they still playing with Jets?
Yeah, that's weird. You guys are weird freaks.
What about those standards, huh?
I live by my own standards. I live by the standards that it's okay to live in a dusty house as long as you meticulously sweep up your jacks. I live in a world where it's okay if your parents get divorced as long as they individually love you. I live in a world where it's okay to spend time with your elementary school classmates as long as you meticulously plot eventually murdering them when you get to college.
There's only one clean spot in the entire house, and it's right where he's been playing jacks for the last 17 years. I think we should probably, find our way.
Thor! Cave dirty! Thor! Cave dirty! Whoa!
can't get dust away.
Attach twigs to end a long twig. Observe.
Wizard!
I'm wearing skin of bear. Everything I touch gets swept by my back.
Who to choose as leader?
One of us will leave this community, and the other will be ritually sacrificed to volcano.
One of us will lead bears into our midst.
And the rest will wear bears. I turned that around on
One of us found a way to make things out of nothing.
You don't have any nothing. You have lots of bears.
I call it tool.
So, this is what the Interactive History Museum is like.
Yeah, I understand this was the birth of technology, actually.
Oh, this is how it starts. It ends with the iPad.
Yes.
Now we will all get on Noah's Ark, for flood is coming.
That was rough last night.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, yeah, that was pretty gross, honestly.
I thought taking a poop on stage would be funny.
Was a bitch.
Yeah.
I gotta be honest.
No, we thought the room was going, so that's.
I wasn't gonna have to empty that room
full of
shit, though.
It's mostly just smearing it around.
I know.
We had a pile, and now we have a thin layer around the stage.
Guys, what did you do? There's shit everywhere.
That's mostly technology's fault.
I mean, it's 75% your fault. You gotta take responsibility for the last
time.
You're
gonna
have to mop this up.
Mopping makes more sense than rooming. Yeah.
Mom. Dad. I want to let you know, I'm not gonna go to college. Besides, it's not worth my heart.
You better get good at that.
What do you mean? I gotta follow my heart. I can't be a lawyer or dad or doctor like you.
Now, ever since you were a kid, we got you that thing that spins the little balls. Yeah. You love that thing. Yeah. That's when I knew.
That was a great thing. We worked hard to provide that thing.
That thing is great. I can't remember its name. Did you tell me it?
That.
Babe?
No, I'm not sure if that thing ever really happened.
It didn't. It was organic.
It's called it the thing that has the bubbles in it.
The thing with the bubbles.
It's with a clear dome.
And we worked hard for the thing with the bubbles.
We did work hard for this.
Performing next, scenes from a YA sequel.
Exchange.
assassination. Razor had been right about one thing. There's definitely tension between the Senate and their new elector. But Anton is no fool. He's been in power for less than a week, and already he's doing exactly what he should be, trying to cement the military's loyalty to him. I wonder what else he's doing to win their trust. The Republic Army had been fiercely faithful to his father. In fact, that loyalty was probably what made the late elector so powerful. Anton knows this, and he's making his move as early as possible. The Senate's complaints are useless against a military that backs Anton without question. But they don't back Anton without question, I remind myself. There's Razor and his men. Traitors in the military's ranks are moving into place.
Yes.
Back us. We are the military.
I'm not so sure. What's in it for me?
Good uniforms.
All right, keep talking.
People that will iron those uniforms. Structure. A small island off the Pacific coast that you can call home and sometimes, I don't know, steal people away to and call them your wife.
Sorry, I'm late. I had a compost incident. Anyway, Peace Corps is here and we really love your support.
What's in it for me?
Feelings of fuzziness. Getting water to poor people. Sometimes people sing you a song.
Where's my Pacific island where I can make people my wife?
That's a little culturally insensitive. Also, we're moving people off the island because of climate change. And we're actually getting people to... Islands are not a good place to be right now. But, you know, we can get you an island, and I would love to arrange some dates for you if it was mutually acceptable to that person.
I believe the young bride has spoken for.
I don't want fuzzies and feelings. I want uniforms and people to iron them for me.
Okay, well.
Does the Peace Corps have uniforms?
We have Birkenstocks.
I've been thinking about what to name our baby that we're sharing between the three of us. I was thinking something like dagger or machine gun.
Those sound like powerful names.
What about, like, dagger machine gun?
Perfect.
Like, first name, middle name,
yeah.
Because last name, trifecta.
I'm so glad that we decided to triple surrogate a baby during this nuclear holocaust.
I mean, we need to procreate.
Yeah. Only women are alive now. All the men are dead.
It's the end of the world, and that crazy leader. What will he do next?
I just hope we can take care of our baby, as we should.
Well, six set of breasts between us, we should be okay. I mean, three sets.
So, your extra sets are right here.
We're doing what we can for the United States of America in the future. So.
We appreciate your service.
Thank you. Conscripted milk production is really a real racket for this republic.
So, machine gun, dagger, grenade.
Yes.
Who is your mother?
They did it like a hat trick.
Switch the women in the bed. Nobody knows. We had people guess, nobody guessed it right. So their punishment was nobody knows. Is that normal?
I don't know. Is it fun?
Yes. Machine gun, dagger. Machete loves it.
That's still you, correct?
Ding dong, witch is dead.
You rang? Sorry. What's up?
So he's asking a lot of questions and it's kind of bothering me. I'm kind of trying to hang out in my arcade here. comes in, sat down on a pinball machine. Rude. Wants to know who my mom is.
So rude.
High school.
You did not. You did not.
So
dumb.
Ding, ding, ding.
Do you just put not knowing your mother into all of your games?
Don't question what motivates her. She's going to be our future leader. She
deserves those noises.
All right, senators. They're taking over. And we have to make a stand because the Senate doesn't mean much.
The Senate means everything to me.
Senator Pulaski.
Yes. Senator Johnson.
How can you still have faith when that dude is out there trying to have banks of women and there's nuclear stuff and...
I mean, I don't know about you, but as soon as that mushroom cloud went up, I was like, who cares about the Senate?
I know.
Mushroom clouds mean nothing. The Senate will always stand.
I mean, technically...
Thank you, Senator.
I guess we'll vote for a quorum now. Doing the normal Senate stuff.
So let's name a post office and pass a bill to continue budgeting for the... Yeah, just normal Senate
stuff. Gosh, I mean, this is...
I like a statue of myself.
Oh, I second that.
Oh, I, yeah.
Thank you.
Wait, you're that prodigy. That. You're the Senate prodigy we've heard about.
What? Senator Machete?
You can call me by my first name.
Machine Gun.
Machine Gun? Yes.
Thank you. What's your middle name again?
Oh, you know, another dangerous weapon.
Dagger, isn't it?
Yes! You know my mom.
I could be one of your moms, I'm not sure.
I've been playing in that arcade and all I can think about listening to the ding 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 ding.
I think this Senate session has come to a head. You were chosen to go against that guy who wanted the island. You have to beat him.
Okay.
That's bad.
Who will have the final score? It's definitely her, it's not me!
Yeah, I don't think you should be in love with me either.
One of you might have cancer.
What?
Gas.
Performing next, Teen President presents regular improv, but also a child shows up.
Just so everyone is aware, we've done this show once before, where a child shows up. This child showed up. When I asked him backstage what he wanted to do, he said, I wanted to break everything that's glass. Yes. So we'll see what happens. To get started, can we get a non-geographic location from the audience?
Funeral parlor.
I'm sorry?
Funeral parlor.
Funeral parlor.
Funeral parlor.
We see a beautiful wreath of roses.
Over here in this corner, we see a metal tray on a metal stand with lots of medical equipment on it.
And then over here is a display of all the different caskets you can get. You know, you can get your glue, your ivy, or use some wood if you don't have any money. And all this right here.
We hear a businessman on the phone saying, you're fired. Be interrupting the service, but he is.
Fire! And I'm fired.
I'm sorry, we came to pay our respects.
You wanted to hurry.
Sorry, one of us came to pay our respects.
I was just sewing the last stitch on this one.
Well, it looks absolutely beautiful.
Well,
I'm going to
fight for a long time.
What would I do if I can't
get king?
I'm sorry. I have to apologize. Ronald, very recently. You don't have to give him your keys.
You do.
I got the keys.
That's the best. You're fired. I'm the muscle of the boss man. Yes.
Oh, so, yeah. He's still working in that line of business?
You told me to stitch up this body! Ronald? I thought I did what you wanted!
Ronald, look me in the eye. What line of business? You can't fire me! I'm your best friend!
You have been fired! Yes, you all grew up together, alright? We started the business together, but he moved on to a better opportunity.
No, we're co-signatories! You can't do this!
Co-signatories?
No, we're on the lease together! Ronald, come on! This is a regular day going to a funeral. I didn't know. How did this get so bad? Ronald, please. I'd do anything to get back.
I'm sorry. All right, boss man. Okay, you want to finish stitching this up?
I will slay this bird!
Whoa.
Yeah, fuck!
I was going to say it myself.
Yeah. Oh, and Andy.
What?
We are starving. Huh?
That's my pacifier.
What is this?
My pacifier.
That's your pacifier?
Yeah.
You got a strange thing of putting things in your mouth.
I sucked it.
You sucked it? Oh, take it. Yes, of course take it.
Thank you.
Oh. You know what, Andy? I prefer to be in the apocalypse. I am going to go outside. And you can take your car.
I've got the power now.
just your word. I think he's.
And my voice. And not it.
Sorry. This is.
I have two pacifiers. And one thing is hockey.
Yes, I know. He's. This is my best friend.
This will be what I mean.
I like wet on my hands. Oh my God, when I got to offer a letter to work at Google, I didn't know this was
you,
the environment.
You, I don't.
Childlike atmosphere.
It's a lot of free association, a lot of play. Exactly. That's why we come up with our best stuff.
You go from here. That's why the only thing I need. This car is great, full of babies with pacifiers.
Pacifiers. Okay. Smart pacifiers.
You need to come take it.
No.
Babe doesn't really want to. So,
you just
so you're
the
aware,
phone.
He's giving me two cars, okay? And the only.
Can you see my pacifiers?
Let me get some of that.
You want me to put it in my mouth?
Can I get
it? You want me to actually put it in my mouth?
Yes.
Wow.
It's dedication. And I don't know where that's been. I take it now?
You take it.
How about I put this one in my mouth, too?
No.
It has germs on it? Oh, that's too late now. That's too late.
You're going to jail. You in jail.
I'm going in jail? You know, corporate America's not too powerful. It's too powerful. Like, if I can go in jail, I get to take both of these. How about that?
No, hold on. I call my squad team to get you hurt.
I'm here! Hello, use me!
I got a jail in this.
I thought I was on your special squad team. Remember, I'm your servant.
No, you're not my servant, okay? I'm going to jail right now.
Okay, no, I'll go to jail. I'll go to jail. You don't need to send your squad team to come hurt me.
No, this guy.
Okay, but I'm taking both of these. Is that okay?
No. Put them
on the ground.